Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. Happy Monday, the last week of April. Can you believe that we are moving along throughout the month? Oh my God, we are in the fifth month of the year. Time waits on nobody, and 2021 is moving fast. So today I wanted to share with you my May budget breakdown totals. And before we get started, let me just introduce myself first. Welcome. And if this is the first time you tuning into one of my videos, hey y'all, welcome. Thank you for stopping in. My name is Latasha Brown. I am the owner of Latasha Brown Consulting, the founder of the Budget Pusher blog, and the creator of the Uncover Your Financial Vision Budget Planner. Thank you for tuning in. My hopes is that you leave informed, inspired, and ignited, and that you leave filled up with hope that you landed in a safe place, because this here channel is a no judgment zone. I like to share my journey. I like to provide tips and resources when it comes to personal finances, budgeting, saving money, earning money, you know, inspiration on your financial journey, and just guidance when it comes to meeting your financial goals, taking those actionable steps towards your goals. So thank you for rocking it out. Thank you for tuning in. I greatly appreciate you. And today we're going to just dive right in. But before we get started, please like this video, subscribe to my channel. I would love to have you a part of the Abundant Tribe. It is free, 99. Let's grow together. Let's engage. Let's connect. And then bang on that notification bell if you want to be notified when I drop another video, because you don't want to miss out on the goods. We're going to dive right into this monthly May budget breakdown, y'all. All right, y'all, so let's dive into this May budget breakdown, total breakdown. And what I like to do is I like to start the month with affirmations, jumpstart the month with affirmations, a Bible verse, and quotes. And I have those outlined in my Uncover Your Financial Vision budget planner. And so we're gonna start with the affirmations. And May's affirmation is, prosperity and success is all around me. And the scripture is coming from Psalms 1:3, and it reads, "He is like a tree planted by streams of water that yields its fruit in its season, and its leaf does not wither. In all that he does, he prospers." And that's from Psalms 1:3. And then for the quote of the month, I like to outline known and unknown African-American leaders. And May's quote is, "If you're walking down the right path and you're willing to keep walking, eventually you will make progress." And this was from Barack Obama. So that just inspires me to keep going, even if I'm discouraged, even if it don't look or happen like I expected. If I just continue to keep walking, keep pressing, keep pushing, I will make great progress. So those are the affirmations, the Bible verses, and the quotes from May. And I hope it inspires you on your journey. And I'm going to dive right into my May budget breakdown. And I'm also going to showcase that right here. You will see it up here. And for May, my income is $4,970. My tithes is $500. My savings is $500. My expenses for the month of May is $2,931.36. Special occasion, which is Mother's Day, is $38.64. And then my debt repayment plan is $1,000. So my final is zero. I zeroed out my budget because I followed a zero-based budgeting. So that is what I have when it comes to my budget. Again, it's going to be right here so you can see those totals. And what are my plans? What are my goals for May? So when it comes to personal, you know, what I'm doing, I'm focusing on self-care. I typically go 6 months on, 6 months off when it comes to going to the salon. I feel like it's needed. You know, I like going to the salon to get my hair washed, to get my hair shampooed and conditioned, to get my scalps massaged. Y'all, that is self-care to me. I'm start picking it back up this month, and I just want to, you know, take some time for me, go to the salon, get my hair washed. Oh my gosh. You know, get my scalps massaged, get some treatments to keep my hair healthy. And that's what I plan to do. I have that outline in my budget. And I also plan to continue to make sure that I prioritize my nutrition, my health. So I have a sinking fund for vitamins, you know, nutrition, wellness. So I just want to make sure that I'm busy. You know, mom, business owner, I work. So I want to make sure that I continue with, making sure that I prioritize my health and replenish my body with vitamins. So that's a goal for me to continue to keep that on, even within May and even the months to come, to make sure that I outline it in my budget. Also, with another personal goal that I have is to make sure that I walk at least 30 minutes, 4 to 5 days a week. Walk 30 minutes a day, and then to use the DB method machine daily for at least 10 to 20 minutes a day. So that is my personal goals for me for the month of May. When it comes to my financial goals, I plan to pay down my debt. I'm working on paying my car payment off, which I'm on target to pay that off no later than September. Right now, my balance on my car loan is $6,659.54, and I plan on paying $1,000 on that in May. So I'm on target to get that paid off, and I will be paying that off early. Super excited about that. And then when it comes to my business goals and plans, we have 5 cleans. We have a contract with one of our clients, so we have 5 cleanings already scheduled, booked, and paid for May. So that's all done, and we have those outlined in our schedule. And then my plan is to send out 5 proposals for a client contracts for May. So that is what I'm planning on doing, and getting those proposals out. And that is my goals and plans and my budget outline for May. And if you're new to budgeting, don't feel like it's too late. You know, grab your pen, grab your paper, and outline your income, your expenses. And the thing that I found about budgeting, it changed my whole financial life. It allowed me to see what I'm working with. It allowed me to be in the driver's seat when it comes to my finances. It allowed me to tell my money what to do, where to go, and be more in control instead of having my money control me. You know, knowing what comes in, what goes out, and then keeping my financial goals at the center of my budget. It literally changed my financial life, and I'm continuing to keep learning and growing, based on my financial situation. It's personal finances, and I just like to share my journey just to inspire you on yours. So thank you for tuning in. I greatly appreciate you. I greatly appreciate you rocking with me, and I hope that you have the most abundant week. Drop a comment, let me know what you're working on. Let me know if you have any questions. You know, let's engage, let's connect, and let's grow together. Have an abundant week, y'all. Talk to you soon.